Summary of the Lessons from The Richest Man in Babylon by George Clason. The Richest Man in Babylon by George Clason is another all-time best-selling book. It was written in the 1920s and presents timeless principles which show you how to preserve and grow your wealth. Welcome to Book Digest, the place where you come to be inspired to create a more prosperous future. Babylon is known to be one of the richest early civilizations. It boasts of its great engineering and agriculture, and at a point in time was the largest city in the world. But before it reached its glamorous peak, Babylon had no palace, no walls, nothing of significance. Just like any other place, Babylon had its fair share of rich and poor neighborhoods. Some of its people owned beautiful chariots simply for parades, while others were breaking their backs making the chariots for little pay. One of the people with back-breaking jobs was Arkad. He worked as a scribe, and his job was to carve records into clay tablets for long hours every day. Like any other low worker, Arkad was barely making ends meet, and he also had a family to support. One day, Arkad's fate turned around when he met Algamish, the moneylender, a very rich man. So, with a strong will, Arkad convinced Algamish to become his advisor and mentor him on money matters. Arkad learned the proper ways of saving, budgeting, and investing. He improved bit by bit with the wisdom passed down by his mentor. Arkad kept learning until he mastered the laws of wealth. Algamish, as his mentor, became very fond of him for the person he had become. Arkad, with his experience, multiplied Algamish's wealth even more. And when the old man died, Arkad was given a share of the inheritance. This is the story of Arkad. He started with humble beginnings, but went on to become the richest man in Babylon. As Arkad became wealthier, the king asked him to teach people the practices of gaining wealth so all of Babylon could prosper. In this video, you're going to learn the main lessons that the richest man in Babylon taught. These lessons are still relevant to us today. Lesson number one, save 10% of your income. The first lesson taught to the people of Babylon was to save money. In fact, you should save 10% of what you earn. The logic is pretty basic. Let's say that you're earning $1,000 a month the moment your manager hands you your paycheck. You are not allowed to spend the 10% that will be saved. After the first month, you will have $100 saved. Then the next month, you will have $200 saved and so on. This can snowball very quickly. This leads us to lesson number two, control. You must understand that your day-to-day needs will always equal your income. Remember from rule number one, that you only have 90% of your income to spend. You will be surprised to see that you can actually squeeze your needs into that 90%. Famously, Grant Cardone, a modern billionaire, teaches people to try to live off only 60% of their income, and that is tough. However, the richest man in Babylon focuses on living off 90% of your income, which is achievable. This is why it's important to learn how to budget. The true goal of a budget is to help you understand your spending. Therefore, increase your savings by controlling your spending better. First, make a list of all your monthly needs and wants and how much they will cost. Is the total amount less than 90% of your income? If not, you need to either reduce your spending by cutting out unnecessary expenses or by increasing your income so that you can save 10% of it. Lesson number three, invest your savings. As you're controlling your expenses and saving 10% of your income, you will notice that your savings account will start to grow. Although it's nice to have cash build up, if cash sits in a bank account, it devalues due to inflation. The third lesson that Arkad taught was that every piece of gold you earn is a slave to work for you. This means that to grow your wealth, you have to make your money work for you by investing it. This is where you have to be careful of where you invest your money to make sure you protect your initial investment. When Arkad partnered with a brickmaker to buy and sell jewels, he was tricked and Arkad lost all of his savings. Arkad had to save again and started from an empty purse. This is why you have to choose your investments wisely. Lesson number four, secure your family's future. The wise start to buy houses and land because these assets grow in value over time. When the right time comes, these can be sold at a great price. With some savings and a good track record, financial institutions will allow you to use their money to buy a house. A house is a wise investment, especially if you already have a family or you're about to have one. Lesson number 5, keep practicing your craft and always look to keep learning and improving yourself. There will always be more skills and knowledge to master. The more skills and experience you have, the more real opportunities you attract, increasing your opportunity to earn more money. Arquette also devised the 5 laws of gold. Wealth is reserved for those that know these laws and follow them. Law number 1. Gold comes to people who always save at least a tenth of their income to secure their own family's future. You acquire gold by saving regularly to build wealth. Law number 2. Gold is very eager to work for you when it is invested in the right opportunities. When you find the best place to invest your money, it will gladly multiply for you as the years pass by. Law number 3. Gold clings to its owner who carefully invests it and takes the advice of wise men in handling money. Find yourself a mentor and learn from those who are specialists in handling money. Law number 4. Gold slips away from a person who invests in businesses which he is not familiar with, or by the people who are not skilled in investments. This was Arquette's first mistake when investing. He trusted a brickmaker's knowledge in the dealings of jewelry. Law number 5. Gold flies away from a person who trusts investments that promise impossible earnings or who believes in the advice of tricksters and schemers. You will be amazed that when you have money saved up, many opportunities will come before you, but not all are real opportunities. Remember this, there is always a high risk hiding in every plan to gain great wealth quickly. Learn not to invest for fast returns. Instead, learn to protect your initial investment. Keep these 5 laws in your mind, master them, and your wealth will grow. These lessons and laws are a summary of the main points discussed in George Clason's book, The Richest Man in Babylon, and are still very relevant today. Remember that knowledge alone remains as knowledge. You need to take action. Put into action the lessons you've learned to help increase your wealth. Thank you for watching the video. If you'd like to see more of this content, like and subscribe to be updated with my latest videos. Comment below which book you would like to see next.